Hello, everyone. I am heading to the debut of Sindelar's Institute. It will be held in the public theater in Old Town. Let's see what happens. It should be starting soon. I have to go up here, walk around the platforms, and then get into the theater. Oh, Avi is there. Has the talk started?
Ooh.
I just started. I think I missed the part about Amelia. Yeah. But not that much. Because Avi was also waiting outside. Brogan the Hermit. Cornelius Sindelar. Oh goodness, he grew such a long, magnificent beard. Okay. Ara the Giant in white. Woman in white is quite a fashion statement in Port Presidium.
What's going on?
Did Sindelar forget something?
I'm not sure.
There's some oddly labeled tables. I wonder I should heckle him. You know? Jig-El is there too. Jig-El is there too. But what's all this about campfire? Supposedly, campfire in Ultima Online will allow you to log out safely as long as you have a bedroll. But where's the fire then? Where is it? Seems Ara the Giant is an artist too. I wonder if Sindelar is stuck or something. Okay, Sindelar finally moving around. Suppose you figure out what to say then. Sindelar got stage fright. Wait, does that mean I did not hear a thing of what Sindelar said? Oh my goodness. Maybe I should move up and listen to Broken Seat. Submission box, ask Dr. Helen, double click for more info. Thank you. I think it is a line of sight fault. Something in the game itself. So yeah, now I can hear what Drusilla is saying. Okay. It's just like the issue in church where the pillars block the sounds. Looks like the important part is the sepsis treatment and the doctor's speeches, although I miss Sindelar's speech and part of Drusilla's, so it's not really complete, I guess. Anyway, the newspaper will definitely have its records later on. At least I won't miss Dr. Thiel's questions and answers, which I think people would like to hear as well. Older players probably have seen the Sindelar story before. But basically, Sindelar Institute is a medical institution founded to provide first aid to people wherever they are. And its ultimate goal is to find a cure for the torment. I mentioned the torment is a persistent threat in the setting of Requiem. Torment is like a rabies autoimmune disease. Patients bleed out and become berserk, angry, almost zombified, basically. Back when the campaign launched, this character, Viola Wandren, wanted to join the institute in order to help out, although she didn't really have much medical knowledge beyond first aid. However, due to some time issues with Sindelar's player, the entire thing had to change. So hence Viola is now well known as the local cook. So why am I here then, watching this then? Mostly for moral support of Sindelar. I think Holly asked something, but I can't really hear. I think she asked, from what Dr. Hanlon says, if not done properly, it's unlikely for someone to survive. So I think Holly asked, what happens if you screw up the treatment? Dr. Teo is talking about how to treat. You must first fashion torquinate just about the place that will be removed, which is essentially a tight binding that will stop blood flow to that particular limb. Oh goodness. It wasn't how to treat sepsis, is it? Unless you're talking about the classical method of cutting the limb off. I mean, Ikashev is the ill one. amputating an infected part is, it was a very common method in the age of sail, hence why the idea of a hook hand, a one-legged pirate existed in the first place. Because people didn't really have access to antibiotics, much less knew what exactly, how exactly to recover, to treat it. Avi has something to ask, but I can't really hear that side. And I think the archways are so that the theater boxes can be put up there. It's backstage. Logically, I would not be able to hear what's going on there. But I should be in theory able to hear this part. So it's kind of odd that the walls and things completely block sound. But I guess that's the mechanics of the game map system. Then makes for blind spots. something about medicated drugs from the sounds of it. Sounded like psychiatry, maybe? Psychiatry in our real world 19th century was pioneered by the likes of Sigmund Freud and Carl Jung, among many others. At least, that's what I remember off the top of my head. I did take psychology as an elective in university because you had to know how people think. That's someone else, not Ika Chef, from the looks of it. I can't look at her. It doesn't seem to be a player. Hmm. and it's not an easy thing to treat. The thing is, Ikashen was playing a fool with the tools, so wouldn't he have contaminated it? At least Dr. Teo had the sense to clean it. He is hugging Itasha. Sindelar is explaining how the diagnosis is. listen to the heart.
Yeah.
But this isn't the time for jokes. Earlier they said they would drain the patient of excessive bile and offer her medicine. ask someone to help with a question because they're busy treating the patient. And how would I even get one? Never mind, Ara has gotten it, I think. Of what? For medicine? Oh my goodness, Ara! Bro, what? Cannot understand the question? Ara rolled a 1 in dice terms. That's an absolute failure. Oh, she tried again. 0D0, yeah, that's broken. 17, okay, yeah, she. I think it's a success. a case of indigestion? The easiest solution would be to attempt process elimination in this case. I would recommend fasting and slowly reintroducing each item of food until you can figure out which one in particular is causing the digestive discomfort. Sindelar said, there have been studies to show that one stress can lead to an irritable bowel. You feel more stressed than usual, then that is something that would be good to know. Yep, that's medical advice we can take into the real world as well. Did not mention stress other than what was caused by their discomfort. Figuring out if a food is the culprit may be easier. However, if you are stressing yourself out by being fearful of having these issues in public, then it could still remain a factor. Yeah, you'll worry too much and then you'll become a self-fulfilling prophecy. under for chloroform. No, maybe not. Priscilla says, in a moment we will let the blood from the patient. Sepsis is at its root. Infection has invaded the bloodstream from its source. We will expel some of the blood prior to treating the source to further stabilize her for surgery. Close enough. surgery time, well, kind of squeamish, to be honest. Maybe volunteered to read the note. not sure I heard what Hollis is saying. Inappropriate letter asking about Dior Henlon. Thank you. must have been another weird question. I really am not sure what the question was. So,
my god, this is another dating related question. Well, what do you expect? When you offer the chance to put questions, people are gonna add very silly remarks to it. Now the doctor is wondering, how did they put the not safe for work questions in there? Oh my goodness, to cut open, to show the gallbladder, I hope it goes smoothly. wiping what incorrectly? Sindelar will cut open the stomach around where the gallbladder is. gone to this event as Viola. Really, it was more a toss-up between Ida and Viola. Either of them could have logically gone and Kent says, hey, you shouldn't be here, Viola. Oh no! Harinus is on the rope now. This is a dirty, filthy event. If Calcus could see it being done, he would probably shoot Dr. Sindelar. Yeah. Kinda miss him. I don't think they are. how Sindelar took out a suction pump machine. Draining the gallbladder and blood now. Sindelar asked Ikasha for help. If Evelyn had been here, I think things would have gone a little differently. pull back the gallbladder. I think the patient will be okay. I hope so.
the lumbar suction device, huh? Yeah. Honored his legacy of medicine.
the end of the medical lecture, I probably won't hit in a video though. But I hope everyone else has enjoyed themselves despite the scuff recording and not quite hearing everything. I'll see you next time.